generator, and even a helicopter that ran on radio frequencies, a true free energy device that keeps batteries consistently charged. It took me several months to find him, but when I did, it blew my mind.
Maxwell is a testament to the boundless ingenuity that resides within our continent.
In a groundbreaking moment for Africa's technological landscape, the Harar Institute of Science and Technology, HIT, has officially endorsed one of the most revolutionary innovations in automotive history. Maxwell Sangulani Chikumbutso, the visionary founder of SAIT Technologies, has introduced the world's first self-powered vehicle, a feat that defies conventional science and positions Zimbabwe at the forefront of global energy innovation. The endorsement from AIT's Vice Chancellor, Professor Engineer Quinton Kanhukumwe, marks a defining moment for African ingenuity and technological advancement. Addressing an audience of delegates at the unveiling of Chikumbutso's latest invention, Professor Kanhukumwe's words carried the weight of both scientific credibility and national pride. Here's what this great professor of engineering from one of Africa's leading tech universities said.
Innovation has always been the driving force behind humanity's progress as we confront the mounting challenges of energy scarcity, environmental degradation, and economic inequality. Technology offers a beacon of hope. It is a privilege to stand before you today at this remarkable occasion, the launch of SAIT Technologies' groundbreaking microsonic energy technology. We gather here not only to celebrate technological milestone, but to witness the dawn of a new chapter in energy innovation, born and developed right here on the African soil. For far too long, Africa has been seen as a consumer rather than a producer of technological advancements. SAIT Technologies is changing that narrative. This launch symbolizes a shift towards homegrown solutions designed to meet global challenges. What makes today even more significant is that this breakthrough has been pioneered by one of our own, Maxwell Sangulani Chikumbutso. Maxwell is a testament to the boundless ingenuity that resides within our continent. His work serves as an inspiration not only to Zimbabwe, but to the entire African continent. Supporting local innovators like Maxwell is not just a moral imperative, it is a strategic necessity for our development and competitiveness on the global stage.
This speech has significant implications. Professor Engineer Quinton Kanhukumwe, the Vice Chancellor of the esteemed Harar Institute of Science and Technology, put his distinguished and indispensable scientific career as well as his unrivaled authority as a highly sought-after engineer to fully support Zimbabwe's leading innovator, Maxwell Sangulani Chikumbutso.
The first people who have done that in the world, like us or hate us, that's a fact. We have seen it, we have tested it, it was tested outside the country, it works. So what we have is called a microsonic energy device. But before I got to the microsonic energy device, like where we are right now, around 2013, that's 2003, that's when God gave me the vision. I started to work on it. And that time I was working on three projects. I began to be very much interested in radio frequencies. And I'm so good in radio frequencies. That's something that I know back to back. You cannot confuse me when you talk about radio frequencies. I've sat down with the best professors, best engineers in the world, the likes of Nassim Haramein, if you know him. I've sat down with him in the United States of America. I've sat with the likes of Michael, the great writers of science. They don't believe that I'm not educated. I'm good when you talk about radio frequencies. I'm so good in them. Most of my projects, I'm not boasting, but I'm telling you, you cannot confuse me when you talk about radio frequencies. And I'm good on them. I've started to write my new discoveries.
But who exactly is Maxwell Sangulani Chikumbutso, the man behind this extraordinary breakthrough? Born in 1980 in Butiriro, a densely populated suburb of Harar, Chikumbutso's early years were marked by immense financial struggles. His family's economic hardships forced him to drop out of school at the tender age of 14, halting his formal education. Yet what he lacked in academic credentials, he more than made up for in raw intelligence, relentless curiosity, and an innate ability to innovate. Unlike traditional inventors who built upon structured academic learning, Chikumbutso's knowledge was entirely self-taught. With no access to laboratories or engineering mentors, he worked with discarded electronic components, using them to create rudimentary devices. One of his earliest successes was a makeshift radio transmitter that successfully broadcast over a limited range. This was only the beginning. As a teenager, he went on to design a digital navigator, a turbine engine, and a series of electronic devices that left those around him in awe. His ability to conceptualize and build advanced systems without formal training astounded engineers and scientists alike. Chikumbutso has often attributed his breakthroughs to divine inspiration. He claims that many of his inventions were not the result of trial and error, but rather clear, vivid instructions he received in his dreams.
I started to see visions, and up to until now, I see visions, very clear visions, not even when I'm not asleep. Mm. Those are some of the things that I see. And God started to teach me. I believe God started to teach me. I could hear voices. I started to experiment with some electronic components. No one ever taught me what were the names and the uses of electronic components. It was God.
He describes these moments as revelations, granting him deep insights into energy systems and engineering principles that defied mainstream scientific understanding. In the late 1990s, he intensified his experiments in electronics, developing a variety of functional devices from scrap materials. His work soon pivoted toward sustainable energy solutions, culminating in the invention of the Microsonic energy device in 2009. The Microsonic energy device, according to Chikumbutso, harnesses radio frequencies from the atmosphere and converts them into usable electrical energy. This technology, when applied to automobiles, eliminates the need for fossil fuels or rechargeable batteries. Instead, the vehicle continuously draws power from the air, ensuring an unlimited energy supply. The implications of such an invention are monumental. It challenges long-held scientific principles, particularly the first law of thermodynamics, which states that energy cannot be created or destroyed, only converted from one form to another. If proven scalable, this technology could disrupt the global automotive industry in unprecedented ways. It would render gasoline engines and lithium-ion battery-powered vehicles obsolete, offering a solution that is both eco-friendly and economically transformative. According to Chikumbutso, the prototype vehicles featuring Microsonic energy technology exhibit remarkable performance metrics. Unlimited range. Unlike electric vehicles that require frequent recharging, these cars reportedly never run out of power. High-speed performance. The vehicle is capable of exceeding speeds of 220 kilometers per hour and accelerating from 0 to 100 kilometers per hour in just 2 seconds when in sport mode. Powerful output. The motor generates 160 kilowatts, 215 horsepower, with 320 to 308 m of torque, comparable to standard SUVs. Energy independence. The vehicle also functions as a portable power generator, capable of supplying up to 15 kilowatts of electricity to a household when stationary.
So with this car, you can also use it to power your house. It is a moving generator. When you drive from work back to your home, you can connect your power cable, then you can power your house. It gives you 15 kilowatts power to power your house.
Such capabilities could revolutionize not only the automotive industry, but also energy access in Africa, where millions still lack reliable electricity. The potential socioeconomic benefits of mass producing these vehicles are staggering. Lower transportation costs, reduced reliance on imported fuel, and an overall shift toward green energy solutions. However, Chikumbutso's journey has not been without adversity. He has faced immense opposition, particularly from powerful entities within the oil and automotive industries. He claims that during a visit to Silicon Valley, he and his research partner were poisoned, an event he believes was orchestrated by those who saw his work as a threat to the status quo. This allegation aligns with the historical pattern of disruptive inventors encountering resistance when challenging deeply entrenched industries. Despite these challenges, Chikumbutso's work has received widespread recognition and praise. Zimbabwean President Emerson Mnangagwa has publicly lauded him as an exceptional innovator, emphasizing the importance of supporting indigenous technological advancements. The president has revealed plans to establish a manufacturing plant in Zimbabwe dedicated to producing vehicles utilizing this groundbreaking technology, with production costs estimated at $14,000 per unit. International validation of Chikumbutso's work has also been significant. Foster Gamble, the renowned producer of the Thrive documentary series, took an interest in Chikumbutso's technology and sent scientist Nils Rodnerud to Zimbabwe in 2018 to test its legitimacy. After weeks of rigorous examination, Rodnerud and his team confirmed that Chikumbutso's 500 kilowatts generator operated as claimed. This momentous validation was featured in Thrive 2, a documentary released in 2020 and translated into 15 languages, bringing global attention to this pioneering African invention.
There's good corroboration that they believed he had what he claimed.
True free energy device that keeps batteries consistently charged. It took me several months to find him, but when I did, it blew my mind.
So this is the Microsonic energy device, ladies and gentlemen.
With the official launch of Chikumbutso's self-powered vehicle, Zimbabwe now finds itself in the global spotlight. The potential impact of this innovation cannot be overstated. If this technology proves viable on a large scale, it could earn Zimbabwe a place among the world's leading nations in green energy and transport solutions. It would be a triumph not just for Zimbabwe, but for Africa as a whole, proving that the continent is fully capable of delivering world-class innovations that address global challenges. Maxwell Sangulani Chikumbutso's story is one of resilience, brilliance, and unyielding belief in possibility. His journey from a high-density suburb in Harare to the forefront of technological innovation serves as a beacon of inspiration for aspiring inventors across Africa and beyond.
We are talking of megawatts of power. We have done it.
If history is any indication, disruptive ideas often face skepticism before they are widely accepted. But should Chikumbutso's vision come to full fruition, his invention will not only redefine transportation, it will alter the course of energy history forever. Your perspective matters. How excited are you about the world's first free energy vehicle being invented by Zimbabwean inventor Maxwell Chikumbutso? Share your thoughts and insights in the comments section below. If you like this video, be sure to subscribe to the New Africa Wealth and turn on the notification bell so you don't miss any of our informative future videos. Stay informed, stay engaged, and thank you for watching.